For many people, the end of summer doesn't necessarily mean the end of that golden tan. More and more sun worshippers are turning to indoor tanning to maintain a so-called healthy glow year-round, a trend that's got health officials concerned.
I don't think people realize that the tanning salon results in the same risk as exposure to sunlight. We expect that 500,000 cases of cancer will occur this year. This cancer is related to exposure to ultraviolet light, and those same ultraviolet rays are present in the tanning salon as it is in sunlight.
That danger includes not only an increased risk of cancer and premature skin aging, but skin and eye burns, allergic reactions, and cataracts, the same health risks associated with prolonged sun exposure.
Natural sunlight contains two kinds of radiation that can produce a darkening of the skin. Ultraviolet B radiation is the kind that generally produces the burn, and ultraviolet A radiation is the kind that generally produces the tan.
But tanning by sun lamps is different than tanning by the sun. Each involves both types of ultraviolet radiation, but in differing amounts.
Some of the newer sun lamps produce a ratio of about 10 times more UVA radiation to UVB than the natural sun does. Now, some people used to believe that because those lamps gave off more UVA, which are the tanning rays, that they'd be safer. As a matter of fact, we know now that that UVA radiation produces the same kind of risk in the long term, skin cancer, premature aging of the skin, as UVB.
And recent studies suggest the combination of exposure to the sun and sun lamps increases the likelihood of skin cancer over simply exposure to the sun. From Washington, this is Karen Foley reporting.